What's going on?
Well, if the politics of abortion and the March for Life, even the marchers themselves, have changed dramatically in the 41 years since the Supreme Court's Roe versus Wade decision. Though now, one of the biggest questions of all is whether Washington should even be the focus because the states are playing such a big role. The cold political climate in Washington and the freezing weather hit the March for Life and the anti-abortion movement with a double whammy today. House Majority Leader Eric Cantor summed up the news in the shadow of the Capitol.
Some of you have been marching for over 40 years and have endured many setbacks, including the recent expansion of abortion coverage in Obamacare.
Conservatives are looking to rally the base using the Affordable Care Act as a proxy in the abortion wars. On the 41st anniversary of the Supreme Court's Roe versus Wade decision, the anti-abortion movement is revising the message.
Our theme this year is adoption. There are sadly 1.21 million abortions annually. There are only 18 to 20,000 infant domestic adoptions.
And it's reaching out to the next generation.
I took a social justice class in high school, and we talked about abortion and just like the pro-life movement and stuff, and that's when I really started getting involved. This is my second time here.
Still, Republicans are fighting back against a message that they are waging a war on women. And this week, the Republican National Committee is proposing pushing back on the issue.
This war on women has wrongly been called the war on womanhood when the real war today is actually a war on motherhood.
James Dobson, a longtime voice of this movement, says Washington is taking a back seat in the conversation.
I think that there has not been a receptiveness to that message in a lot of the offices here in this city, and the states are where it's happening.
States now hold the power. In 2013 alone, 22 states enacted 70 restrictions on abortion, according to the Guttmacher Institute, which keeps track of trends in reproductive health policy. So a lot going on in those legislatures.
All right. Thanks very much, Joe Johns, reporting.